I was just focusing on what my strengths are and what the wicket is, because the wicket was a little difficult to bat on. It's not easy to score heavily on this wicket, because to play big shots over this sluggish wicket was a little difficult. So I was just figuring out my options, what I should do, and I was trying to execute that. Once you know your target is a small target, so once you hit one boundary, then you don't need to take a lot of risks. I mean, we were batting first, so we were still figuring out what is the safe total. So I think that was a difference. Maybe they were rotating the strikes after hitting a boundary. So yeah, but in the end, it was a good match.
But did you think Australia changed something up in the middle overs?
No, not really.
What do you think could have been the total had it not been for the kind of short selection
that? See, we almost pulled off this game as well, but on this wicket, around 140, 145 would have been a very good score, because as I told you, over here, there was low bounce and it was difficult to hit big shots. So it's always difficult on these kind of wickets to chase totals. We were trying our best. We were just figuring out. He was just trying to take the game deep and trying to get us to a safe total, which he tried. And I think we were short by 15, 20 runs, but still gave us a fighting total. We had something that we could fight on. So I think that was the plan which he was trying to execute. It always goes both ways, because once you bowl a last over in a close game during that over, it is sometimes 50-50, because you try your best, you're always clear in your execution. Some days it works, some days it doesn't. So yeah, nothing to be worried about. Yes, we wanted to close the game in our favor, but it's okay. This happens, because as I told you, death bowling is a little difficult in any situation.